Hey guys, my name is Kriyanche and welcome to episode 14 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you're able to automatically fill buckets with water using a logistics pipe network, and in this episode we'll start talking about how you're able to automate the immersive engineering metal press using logistics pipes. So let's get started. So as the main ID for this metal press, I use the gear press. So this will work with pretty much any press, but you will have to tweak the timing a little bit if you use other materials, but it will work just fine with anything else. So like always, I've got myself a cool tutorial world. I won't be talking too much about how I actually set it up, like the basics that I always do. So of course the resource chest, the two inputs for power and the regular stuff. You should know by now how that actually works. If not, the video is linked right now. So I will be talking about how to actually automate the gears today. It may seem a little bit, quite easy at first, but there's a little bit more to do than you actually think. As you can see right here, I had to implement a little bit of redstone logic, because the way the metal press works will kind of bug it out sometimes. So what I did is, as you can see, I got myself two chests, one for the input and one for the output. The output has the actual crafting logistics pipes set to it, which has currently the recipe for 4 copper ingots will give you 1 copper gear, set up to the satellite pipe, which I hooked up to the other end. But of course, if you want more recipes at a time, you can use a chassis pipe and some crafting modules, so that will work just fine. Then of course, in the middle, I got myself the line to actually power this metal press, so that is pretty cool. And then on the right is the actual logic that goes on with this machine. So because you need to put in 4 items at a time, and there's a little bit of a delay before you can actually put new items in, I couldn't just hook up the satellite pipe straight up to the metal press. That simply didn't work because it would just shoot out items everywhere and yeah, create a big mess, not something you want. So for that I had to use thermodynamics as a solution and a chest as the buffer. So if I were to request, let's say, a gear, the 4 copper would be sent into the chest. I hooked it up to a comparator, so this timer will only run when there is actually an item in this chest, so no unnecessary server lag for you. Of course, a NOT gate to invert the signal, and a timer, which is set to 4 seconds or 4000 milliseconds, keep that in mind. And then hooked up to that is a redstone repeater to pretty much lengthen the pulse you get from a timer, because the pulse by itself is not long enough to activate this servo. Then on the servo, I set it to only activate with a high redstone signal and take out 4 items at a time. You do have to use one of the higher end servos, so either Signalum or Anderium, because the extraction rate is too slow with the other, item ducts, and that will mess up the timer a little bit, so yeah, keep that in mind. This is a pretty cool demonstration, so let me quickly do that for you. As you can see, 192 copper. Let's request, let's say, 4 gears. As you can see, the copper is sent to here. Comparator will invert. This thing will toggle over. This will unlock it. As you can see, power is flowing through. The copper is being sent through it. At the same time, the next pulse is being sent over. The copper is being put into the metal press. The metal press will do what it's supposed to do. But the gears automatically into the chest, which has the crafting pipe to it, and then it will be automatically sent to the request. Pretty awesome. And of course this will work quite well with multiple gears at a time, so you can automatically craft copper gears, ding gears, bronze, whatever you want, as this thing will only pull out 4 at a time anyway, so that shouldn't really cause any conflicts unless you really mess up the requests at the same time. But yeah, I haven't had any issues with that personally myself. And with that guys, I will be wrapping up this episode. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed and most importantly found it very educational. If you did, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. Be sure to like, comment and subscribe. Or of course, if your feelings are more complicated like that, let me know what's up. And with that, I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.